Hi, I'm Barbara Dill, and this is my shop. I've made a series of videos on multi-axis spindle turning. I also wrote a book, but I think being able to see how they look on a lathe and hear somebody talk about it helps understand this area of wood turning more than if you're just reading or just fiddling around in your shop. I was always fascinated with multi-axis spindles ever since I saw them in the mid-90s. And I made a lot of things in the 90s, but I didn't know what to do after I turned the axis and created something, and so it got boring. And in 2006, I really decided to figure out if there's a way to understand multi-axis spindle turning, if there's a way to understand what these spindles have in common. So I teach because I want people to understand how to think about it. I don't teach to show people how I do a specific piece that I've turned. I want you to see the process so that you can create your own voice. So today's video is just going to be one spindle. It's going to be, I'm going to make a simple spindle that has two parallel axes and a profile on each axis. I call this the gateway spindle, the gateway to an addiction of multi-axis spindle turning. So if you've never tried this, watch this video and throw a piece of wood on the lathe and see what happens. If you're interested in knowing more, I have a book out, I have papers that I've written, and I'll have a whole series of videos that break it all down into short sections. So enjoy this. So I start by taking a rectangular piece of wood and finding the center on each end. I use a little jig that I make out of yogurt tops. They help me find centers as well as find angles that I use. And I'm going to press it between centers. And if you notice, I have a four-prong drive center that's a half inch in diameter on the headstock end, which helps bite into the wood. And I use primarily two tools. This one is a half inch bowl gouge that I have sharpened as a roughing gouge. And you'll get to see that in a minute, the way it works with the wood. And I'm just quickly going to create a cylinder from this rectangular piece of wood. Okay, here's a view from my viewpoint. The way that tool approaches the wood and cuts. I like to use a tool that will give me the smoothest surface because none of us like to sand. So I'm just taking out the flat spots there. And now the next thing is to scribe a line through the center. In this case, I've decided to do two parallel axes that are in the same plane as the center axis, meaning they're 180 degrees apart. So I mark one and two on the top and the bottom, and they're parallel. So now on each end, I have marked a half inch, which gives me space to not only take notes, but then the ends won't be so close to a fragile part of the spindle once I turn it. And now I'm just going to turn the lathe on slowly and scribe a circle on each end that is about the same distance from the center axis, and that now creates on each end. I have a place to put axis one and axis two, and I think these will be parallel axes like some of the ones I've been talking about. So now all I have to do is push the ends in on each end and then start turning. So on this spindle, it's the archetype parallel axes. I'm going to turn a cove and a bead and a cove on one axis, and then I'm going to put it on the other axis, and I'll turn a bead, a cove, and a bead. Starting a little bit ahead of that black line because I know the bead has to be on the outside of this cove. So So here's the bead in the middle, and I'm going down into a cone here. The deeper I go, the more dramatic it will be, up to a point. But it might get so dramatic that it would break, so I don't want to do that. But always on a cove, you're going downhill, creating this cove, and then on this bead, and then a cove down here. Let's see now if I can capture this any better. So I have the tool handle down, the bevel's hitting the wood, and then I'm going to find where I can slice the wood with this tool. I'm always going downhill from higher to lower so I don't cut against the grain. I take nice slow cuts. And here's another angle so you can see more clearly what I'm doing. Speed does make a difference, and I do like to turn as fast as I can and still feel safe. I'll show you what that looks like. It's just a smoother cut that way. Okay, this axis is done. So now I'm going to take it off. And that was axis number one. And now I'm going to put it on axis number two. I've already pressed those holes in. So I don't have to put a tremendous amount of pressure on this now. I don't have to move the tool rest because the axes were in the same location. And now that's what it looks like. And I'm going to turn. I'm going to turn a bead on top of that cove, a cove on top of that bead, and a bead on top of that cove, and sometimes it helps me to draw in because it's a little confusing. So let's start. I'll start with the cove in the middle first. So here's that cove in the middle. I guess you're wondering, well, how deep do you go? Well, I stop and start a lot just to see where I am, because there's really no answer for that. It depends on the diameter of the wood. It depends on how deep your first axis was. And it's just something you learn by doing this a lot. And by turning a lot of these spindles, your skill level increases. It takes some practice to be able to cut a piece of wood smoothly when you're only hitting it once a rotation. I do want to go deeply enough so that these two arcs intersect, which they have there. I can go deeper and make it thinner if I would like. But now that I have that done, I'm going to start on my beads. And the way I do that is I make a V-cut on each end so I have a place to roll the bead over. I use two tools primarily. One is this spindle gouge that sharpened to 30 degrees, give or take, off the bar. And then my faithful roughing bowl gouge that I use as a roughing gouge. So now I'm going to use a spindle gouge to make those V-cuts. I usually love to turn freshly cut wood, because it cuts so much easier and it's softer than dried wood. And sometimes it's really hard to make these cuts, so you want a soft wood, but then I like hardwoods, so green hardwoods work for me the best. So there, I'm making a V-cut there. I always stop and start my lathe a lot just to see what I've done. I want to make sure that that V-cut is on the outside of that cove, and I can back it up just a little bit towards the headstock to make that happen. Okay, this bead is on top of the cove there, and I've thinned out the profile of the bead, and I've gone a little deeper on the cove, and now I'll work on the bead on the other end, which means I will make a V-cut down here as well. I use the tool that makes the smoothest cut. I could use my spindle gouge for everything, but I find that with my bowl gouge sharpened like a roughing gouge, for long surfaces of coves and maybe the top of a bead, I have better luck making a smooth cut. The last thing in the world I want to do is to sand this stuff for hours and hours. So now it's time to stop and see what's happening down here. Yes, the bead is going to be on the correct side of the cove there. So now it's just a matter of, as I make these final cuts with this light on, you can see the wood dancing. And this is one of the most fun parts of doing this kind of work, is watching the wood as the axes spin around on the lathe. So that's how that spindle is done. Continuing this. All the sanding on these arc types should be done off the lathe. If you try to sand it as it's rotating, you're going to interfere with these wonderful intersections of the profiles. So I always sand these off the lathe. So now what? So now you know how to do one idea. Now, if you understand what the variables are, you can do things like do that on three parallel axes, or do it on two twisted axes, then twist them at 90 degrees or maybe 120 degrees, and then use a fatter piece and shorter piece of wood and see how that looks. And then you can start adding other segments to a multi-axis spindle, maybe a circular type or maybe another arc type, a twisted or a parallel arc type. All the axes can be placed closer to the center of the original spindle or closer to the outside. They can be separated by 90 degrees or 120 degrees, or they can be randomly separated at any kind of separation that you want. There are a lot of other variables, a lot of other ways to play with this. So continue your playfulness, and I think you're going to love it. One thing I like to tell people when I teach is, if you're just beginning to do multi-axis spindle turning, start with small ideas, play around with them, save your samples with the ends marked about what axes you use. And then as you get more experience with it, those small ideas can go into something that's very different and a lot of fun. And you'll find your own voice that way. Here's a list of the other videos that I'm working on. I've broken down a systematic way to think about this into various shorter segments. One is a brief explanation of this multi-axis spindle turning, a conceptual way to understand it and think about it. Then I go through the basics of quadrant one, the basics of quadrant two, the basics of quadrants three and four. And then there's a segment on all about the variables that apply to each one of these groups or families of spindles. And then I go over tools, tricks, and strategies that I've discovered through the years I've been doing this, all about split turnings, and how exploration leads to discovery, how if you start small, then you can develop your own ideas and you'll surprise yourself with some of the forms that you'll find. And then I'll go into a few projects. I'll demonstrate making a three-sided twisted cup, a twisted candle holder, and a goblet from one piece of wood. And I also always love to talk about the other people who do multi-axis work and how we are all so different. And there's so many ways to do this on a lathe. My website is www.barbaradill.com. And there are links there to the papers that I've written and to my YouTube channel, which has some videos on it. And my book was published in 2018. It's sold on Amazon. The end, or maybe, is this just the beginning?